everyone, my name's Colleen. Thank you for joining me today for a 30-minute strength circuit. All you need is two handheld weights, light, medium, heavy, your choice. Remember, anything in your house will work. Dumbbells, plates, water bottles, soup cans, or simply body weight. You can have multiple options for your weight so you can swap along the way. Just make sure you can safely hold those weights in your hands. And then you need a mat or a soft surface nearby so that you'll have that in the future, so that you'll have something for padding on your joints. And then you'll also need one single gliding disc or something similar to this. If you do not have one of these, don't worry. If you're on a hardwood surface, tile surface, you can simply use a dish towel, something like that, it'll still glide. Or if you are on a carpeted surface, you can use a paper plate, a frisbee, anything like that will work. So grab water so you can rehydrate along the way. Remember, I'm your coach, not your boss, so listen to the body, stay hydrated. Grab that equipment, clear the space so that you have a little bit of space to move side to side, front and back, and then make sure you have all your weights, your mat, and that gliding disc, and we're going to get started with a warm-up. And then all I want you to do is equipment-free, roll the shoulders back and down three times, think of lifting up, rolling back. At the back, pinch the shoulder blades together, broaden the chest, and then roll it back one more time. And then I want you to take a peek down at your feet. After you have the shoulders back and down, pull that belly button into the spine, soften the knees, squeeze the glutes for me, and I want you to promise me your feet are side by side, about as wide as the hips, and your toes are pointing straight at me. And then all I need you to do is think, could you sit back and down into your hips by pulling the belly button in, bracing the core for that Mike Tyson punch. Hands can come to the hips if that feels best, but I want you to just walk the toes out, weight in the heels of the feet, sit back and down into your squat. Ready? Let's go. Here, can you start to feel how your hips, knees, ankles, and feet feel? The answer should be not pain. So what do you do if you feel pain? That means you don't go as low. You make sure if the lower back feels pain, you're engaging that core. Maybe place the hand on that belly button. Make sure it feels like it's braced in and not just hanging there. And then this is your pace. You don't have to be with me. It's all about moving through that lower body. Sitting back into that toddler chair. Four, three, two, one. Stand tall. Think of your right leg. Lunge to the front. Two, squat, two, down. Right leg back, two lunges, rear. Two lunges together. Right leg front lunge, two. Squat, two. Right leg lunge, two. Back. Together, two. Can you make it seamless? Two. Squat, two. Rear lunge, two. Right leg moves. Two. Is your chest still proud? And are your lunges long? Both knees bend. Think elevator versus escalator. Change the elevation every time. Give me two. To the front. Center squat. Back, two. Give me two. Left leg to the front. Lunge. Squat, two. To the back, left. Squat, two. To the front, left. Squat, two. Make it work. Back heels up. Center. To the front, left. Back heels up. Take it back. Use your hands for balance. If you're a little wobbly, make your feet wider like train tracks. This move here should get the heart rate elevated just a little bit. It's a lot of lower body power, but you're moving. Can you give me two? Two. Take it back, one more lat. Can you get lower? Two squats to the front, center. One more, back, two, one. Two squats, skin a tall. Shoulders out of the ears, reach up tall. Clasp those hands. Extend belly button, fingers up. Roll down. Then, I want you to step the feet wide, turn those toes to the corner. Lateral lunge to your right. Press off the heel just to center. Hands to hips, up. Up, feel power from the heel. Press, soften in that left knee. Give me four. Three, is your chest still up and are you still looking ahead? One more, go down and hold. Take that palm down on that left arm, or that right arm, excuse me, left arm comes down. Open up through that spine. So look up, down. Are your toes still soft in your shoe? Give me two. One, center it. Lunge to the other side. Left, center. Left, center. Promise me your jaw is relaxed. Your forehead isn't scrunching up, and you have a big press up, down, up. Soften in the left and the right knee at the top, and when you bend over, you don't hyperextend the right knee. It's still got a soft bend. Give me three, two, one more. Down and up, go down, hold. Bring that palm down on that left side. Right arm meets it. Open up, open, close. Feel that thoracic spine start to get some synovial fluid through the spine. Open up. Give me three. Give me two. One. Close those arms. Center it out. Bring the feet in. Now, I want you to think, roll the shoulders. Deep breath, get a sip of water, warm up over. So, grab your weights. You're gonna stand, keep the glider nearby, but promise me it's not a hazard that's gonna cause you to do an unintentional split. After you grab your sip of water, you can pick a weight that's maybe a little heavier, but I want you to always know the weight you start with is not the weight you have to end with. So if you pick up a weight and then halfway through you're like, my goodness, or you start to hoist, lower the weight or drop it completely. Remember, modifications, they're not weakness, they're wisdom. So I want you to roll those shoulders out of the ears, soften in the knees, belly button tight. Then I want you to take those palms into the sides of the legs, thumbs to knee, and give me a hammer curl. Both arms together, toes are wide, heels planted, soften in the knees, belly button in. Ready? Up and down, let's go. Up. Fully extend at the bottom. I want you to feel like you're pumping the bicep up and you let the elbow go all the way at the bottom. Protect that tendon. If you are doing any of this, your weight's probably too heavy. So I want you to be still through that body. Let the bicep work. Promise me the elbows aren't doing any of this either. Let it be muscle work, not swinging, and I want you to have the elbows pinned at the ribs. And if you need to, what do? Give me a kickstand, one leg back. Do you feel your biceps start to get that heat? Answer's yes. Give me four, three, two, one, hold it up. Now those weights, they're at your shoulders, right? Step the feet out. Are your toes still wide in your shoe? Answer is yes. Now, this is where if your weight becomes too heavy, what do? You lower it. You drop your weights, but you don't compromise your form, and you don't arch that lower back. So pull your belly button in, right arm only. Take those palms to your face. Face them in. Arnold press right arm. Up, down. So rotate to knee, then to your face. Down. Shoulder rotation, shoulder power. When you press overhead, can you promise me it's right in front of your head? So instead of behind, you protect that shoulder girdle. by pressing directly in front of your head in that peripheral view. And is your right shoulder starting to get fatigued? If not, can you press a little higher? Control the weight on the way down. Give me 4, 3, 2, 1. Left arm, let's go. Up and down. Rotate to me, to you. Is your jaw relaxed? What about your toes? Did you start to curl? If this tempo doesn't work, what do? Half time. Just keep moving. Build that strength. Just like my shirt says, we do this for ourselves, right? Not for anyone else. So I want you to do what works for you. Can you give me 4, 3, 2, 1 more. Up, palms in, right at the shoulders. Wiggle the fingers, make sure you're not losing feeling. Are your knees still able to bend? Can you still feel all the lower body extremities because you're about to use them? Relax that jaw. Promise me your forehead isn't clenched. Now, squat down. Little press up. Mini squat. Parallel feet, toes to knee. Pop your toes if you aren't sure. Pop your toes. If you can't, sit back in the heels. Sit in your toddler chair. Reach for the top shelf. Reach for that top shelf. Sit in your toddler chair. Reach for the top shelf. Can you promise me you're always looking ahead and up in the direction you're going versus down to the floor? Combo movements. Compound. Working muscles together. Give me 4. Cut it into 2, remember. You squat, stand, press. 2 more. Stand, press. 1 more. Get low. Stand tall. Press it up. Just press. Together. Elbows narrow. Chicken wings. Pull them in. You have 4, 3, 2, 1. Let those arms drop. Shake those shoulders out. If your weights are too much, what do? You drop some, but you're going to use them for your lower body this time. Roll the shoulders. Promise me, if you need hydration, you'll take small sips along the way. And then I want you to start in a narrow squat. That means parallel, hip width, toes to knee. Rock from the balls of your feet to your heels. Then plant your heels, pop your toes, shoulders back and down. Relax your jaw, give me that proud posture. Squat down, 2 counts down, 2 counts up. Ready, let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. If the weight's down by the side, it makes you start to tip over like a teapot. You can take them here, goblet style. But I want you to use your counts. 2, 4, 3, 2, stand tall. 4, 3, can you get lower? 4, 3. Give me 2 more just like this. Get used to pulling the belly button in. 1 more. Now get low. 4, 3, 2, 1. Right leg steps out. 4, 3, 2, 1. Step out again. Wide squat. Step it in. Now step narrow. Left leg out a little. Left leg out a lot. Wide. Left leg in a little. Back to parallel, down and up. Right leg out. All the way out with the right. Now in a little. Parallel, down and up. Left leg out. All the way out. In a little. Parallel. Pause here. Now I want you to think. You have your parallel. You have your little bit of a wide squat and then your wide stance. We're gonna cut out the mid stance, go straight to wide, parallel. If you can let those weights hang long and still keep your shoulders back and down so I can read the logo on your shirt, I need you to do that for me. Pop your toes up. Plant your heels. You only have a few of these, so we're gonna make them count and we're gonna make them your best. Are you ready? Four counts. Four, three, two, one, wide right. Parallel. Wide left. Parallel. Wide right. Parallel, down and up. Four, three, two, one. Wide left. Maybe center, single time. Down, wide, center, wide. Can you stay low? Basement. Don't get out of it. Just narrow. Step wide. Step wide. Are your shoulders still back? Chest and breath. Can you burn those quads? Now those arms. What are they doing? When you step, can you give me a bicep curl? Like that hammer curl, you already did it. So when you step right, curl. Step left, curl. Curl, make it work. Extend that arm every time. At the bottom, then curl it up. Dump your shoulder. Four. Get lower. You can do it. I know it. Give me two. One more, make it your best. Get low. Right. Center. Left center. Stand up. Shoulders. Weight. Lower body. Back of the body. Back. So do you have the right weights? Do you need a drop weight? Balance. It's gonna come into play. So is your glider. So take that glider, put it behind your left foot. So what I need you to make sure, feet are side by side and your heel is off the back of the glider. So if it's not, what happens? Like splits, that's what happened. So I need you to promise me your heel's off. So if I told you to press back or press to the side and drop your heel, you would stop. Then I want you to plant your right foot, drop your heel. Spread your toes wide. Take those weights up into goblet. Then I want you to just think about taking your left leg, sending it back into a lunge. Then I want you to give me that single leg deadlift. So lift up, hinge, find your glider, stand tall again. Press out, hinge, flex the foot, heel the ceiling, find that glider, slowly pull it in. Take your time. Quality versus quantity, always. You have a time, not a target. So always build the balance, build the strength. If you feel like you're gonna fall over, what do? You tap down. No injuries. Pull it in, stand tall every time. Grab that glider, pull. When you pull, can you press into that glider more than you think you need to? Use your quad. Press, pull, stand. Give me two. One. Go out. Just your deadlift. Lift. Lower. Slow and steady. Lift. Lower. Flat back. Shoulders down. Promise me you're not rounding in the shoulder. Shoulder blades back. So promise me you're not here. Here. You lift. Glider. Lift. Glider. Feel the cheek pattern on your face really contract. Drop. Contract. Drop. Give me two more. Front foot. Is it wide in the toes? One more. Stand up. Switch your feet. Now, roll the shoulders. Is your heel off the back of the right foot? Yes, always. Goblet style hold, grip on that weight. Ready? Lunge it back, hinge. That means chest comes over the quads. You hinge at the hips, tail feathers to the ceiling. When the leg is back, lift, flex your foot. Drop, find that glider, pull it in and stand. Pull, press, lift, drop, find, pull it in. Again, press it back. Press and lift, stand. Balance is different for everyone, every day, every side of the body. So don't rush it. Find your balance first, then lift. Brace your core. It'll help. Look at something that's not moving. When you deadlift, look at a couple feet on the floor in front of you. That's the direction your neck is going. Keep that cervical spine in alignment. Pull it in. Out. Lift, flex your foot. Drop it down. Pull it in. Keep it going. Give me three more. Glide out. Lift up. Two more. Pull it in one more time. Find the glider. Glide it out. Hold it. Here. You're going to just lift. So make sure your wide leg train track. Goblet, flat back. Lift, lower. Dead lift. Let's go. Back, heel, lift, flex it. Up, down. Is your front heel planted? Soften in that standing leg. Belly button to spine. Protect that lumbar spine. Pull it in. Draw the navel in. Can you give me four? What feels like four of your best? Flex your foot. Two. One. Find your glider. Pull it in. Deep breath. Get a quick sip of water. Pull the weight off to the side. Sip of water small. Promise me you don't chug a gallon. Then I need you to find your mat. Keep the weights just nearby, but off to the side. Find your glider. And I want you to be able to have your hands on your mat or an extended position where your knees can find the mat if they need to. So, start in tabletop. And I want you to recognize this is not tabletop. This is where I'm dropping my belly into my mat. So I want you to really put little suction cups underneath your palms. Press away from the floor. Flatten out that back. Shake out the head, yes or no. Then I need you to extend your right foot without the glider into a plank. But keep that left knee down. Put the glider under the left foot. I need you then to extend the left foot with the glider. But I want your plank to be strong. So promise me when you extend, you're not here. Because lower back out, right? So you're also not here. I want you to be strong. I couldn't lift your leg if I came up and tried to. If you need to, knees are on the mat. Your left foot still has your glider. So you'll just be here and long. You can still work. No excuses. Now, if you're in your full plank or in your modification, ready? Fun things are coming. So I want you to get in that plank. Gaze is right between your fingers. Take that leg out to the side. So hip abduction. Pull it back. Now pull knee to chest. To the side. Sweep. In and out. Obliques. Middle of that core. Slice it up. Hips. If you feel your form starting to compromise, what do you do? You do what you can, then you rest. Then you lift yourself back up. If you need to, you can make a fist for a wrist. Come up, hip, knee to chest, hips, knee to chest. Can you give me four more? Belly button to spine, draw it up. Give me two. One more, out to the side. Up to center. Drop those knees. You should feel the fire right in the center of the core. Give me a few of those cat and cows. Drop the belly, look up through the lashes. Let that expansion happen through the entire front core. Tuck the chin gently. Arch that back. Drop the belly again. Gently look up. And then all you need to do is get the glider under your right foot. So, can you step into either your modified plank or your full plank? So if you're modified, you're... Right leg has glider, left knee stays down, and you extend the right leg, and it'll go out, and it'll come in. If you're in your full plank, step your left leg out first. Get your strong flat shoulder blades, and then gaze right out in front of your hands. Promise me you're not grinding your teeth together. Then I want you to lift into your full plank. Send that glider leg out. Sweep it to the side for me. Let's go. Side. Slice it up. Side. Slice it up. Remember, no race here. Take your time. Success is definitely not here in your time. If it starts to become too much for the wrist, you drop down, take that break, get back into it when you're ready. Maybe you hit that modification. Four more. That means three more. One more side. Make it count. Side. Slice it up. Drop your knees. I want you to go ahead and give me that cat cow again. Really expand that core. Drop the belly. Look up gently through the lashes. Drop the belly. Really feel yourself drop. Arch up back. Big inhale, exhale. Then pull the chin into the chest and look down as you lift that tailbone and back up to the ceiling. Again, drop the belly. Gently look up through the lashes at the ceiling. Relax the face. If you're grinding the teeth, let the tension go. Deep breath. Drop the chin into the chest. Arch the back up. And then really quick, I want you to just make sure that you don't just start. Come up to that kneeling position. Just shake that head out. Yes. No, roll the shoulders, because anytime you plank, that's full body, shoulders, arms, legs, glutes. The entire body has to work, including your mental state, because it's all about mind-body connection. Take a deep breath for me. Then I want you to go ahead and come back down on your hands and knees and give me one more set of work. So, hands and knees, glider under your left foot. So remember, what's your mod? Right knee's down, extend left, and all I want you to do is think about drawing your knee in, drawing your knee out, and then just lift. Find the glider, in, out. If you're on your glider, you're gonna do something similar in the full plank. So I want you to first walk, right leg out, find the full plank. Then you're going to knee. Then I want you to think about hiking up with one leg. down. Knee, pike your hips up. Knee, pull your hips up. Knee, lift your hips. Use your core. Give me two more. Knee, pike. One more. Drop. This time, child's pose, separate, reach away. Settle into that, really reach the fingertips away. If you have fists, relax the hands. Then come back up. This time, I want you to think, how did you feel if you took the modification and it felt great or it was hard? Good, do it again. Then switch your feet. So this time, can you give the right foot your glider? If you're on your knee, quick refresher. Slice it up, spin it back, flex your heel, lift it to the ceiling. Flex your heel, feel your glutes. Same work that we're gonna do in that pike, it's just a little bit less in the hands and a little bit less in the joints. Then if you're ready and you want it, step out with the left, find the full plank, brace the shoulders, knee in, pike up, knee in, lift your hips, pike, pike. I want you to think, instead of pulling up through the shoulders in the pike, lift through your hips. Power through that quadricep. Power. Not fast muscle, not momentum. Give me three. Two. One more. Drop your knees. Then I want you to find a kneeling position. Say bye to your glider. When you find a kneeling position, find it comfortable for you. So if kneeling back like this bothers the ankles, the knees, sling the legs out to the side, because all you're gonna do is clasp those hands for me, flex the palms, round that upper back, drop the chin into the chest. Take a big deep breath here. Then take those hands up overhead. Give me a big arm circle. Clasp those fingers behind you. And I want you to stay where you are, but I want you to really press back and down. Round the shoulders back and press down. And then here, I want you to not fall over, but I do want you to lift your chin just gently. Promise me you can still swallow. And then drop that ear to your right. Can you lower your shoulders? Gently drop the ear to the left. Come to a seated position. Lengthen the legs. Just point the toes to me. Pull them in. Make sure your hips feel okay. Wiggle the ankles, circle. Then come up and give me a seated figure four. Cross that left over the right. Adjust the sit bones so you can sit up tall. Press the shoulder blades back. Ankle circles. Make sure you feel that hip and glute opening up on that left side. And then I want you to take a big inhale. Exhale, start to just drop that left foot to the ground. As long as there's no pain in the joints and you feel that glute opening and stretching across, you're in good zone. So go ahead and breathe through it. Breathe. Pull it up. Foot down. Switch your sides. Readjust the sit bones, ankle circles. Then shoulders proud. Slowly drop that top foot to the floor and open up the hip and glute. Feel it twist around. Breathe. If you are relaxed in your jaw, good. If you're not, relax it. If you're grinding your teeth, stop and let the jaw go. Lift those knees back up. Find a comfortable seated position. Shake that head out, roll the shoulders. Thank you all very much for joining me today for 30 minutes of full body strength conditioning. Remember to rehydrate, keep stretching if you need to. Most importantly, I hope you all stay very well, and I will see each and every one of you again real soon.